The Cabinet Secretary for Sports Ambassador Amina Mohammed has declared that all outstanding debts owed to sports federations in Kenya will be cleared soon. The sports fund was expected to be the magic bullet that will solve the financial problems that have bedeviled sports federations in Kenya, but it has proved to be a double-edged sword. Mukami Wambora tells us more.
The national women's team, the Harambee Starlets, reported to camp yesterday ahead of their Olympic qualifier against Zambia after the Football Kenya Federation were forced to postpone the camp due to lack of funds.
The fund was created by the president for this work. So if the fund does not work, then what will work? Tumejoin na federation zingine, na tuongea na one voice. Tunataka PS atueleze shida yake ni nini. Kwa nini anazuia funding ya sportsmen kwa hii country?
The Kenya Rugby Union, while naming the squad this morning, that will take part in the Africa Sevens next week, which doubles up as the Tokyo 2020 Olympic qualifiers, also shared their sentiments.
To the Ambassador Kaberia, who is the administrator of the sports fund, we are aware that rugby has monies that have been approved, and those monies look like they're stuck somewhere. So we have been sending teams out there this year with very minimal resources for preparation, and therefore we are not giving ourselves the best chance to succeed.
In June, the sports fund was morphed into the Sports, Arts and Social Development Fund. The Ministry of Sports were given control of 55% of the fund, 35 for sports, while 20 was allocated to heritage and arts. But there are mandatory requirements each federation must follow to facilitate disbursement of funds. The federations must submit an annual calendar of activities and budget for the year. They are also required to submit audited financial statements within 1 month after holding the annual general assembly. And each federation, club or agency seeking assistance must have complied with the registration requirements and must be in full compliance with the Sports Act 2013. Most federations have insisted that they have been compliant with these requirements. And earlier today, the sports CS Amina Mohammed, while paying the Harambee Starlets a courtesy call, promised a more streamlined use of the sports fund.
We have to have structures in place that actually allow those funds to flow to their desired destination, right? And that's what we are putting in place now, and making sure that they are seamless, but also that the time frame from the approval of resources in the fund to the disbursement, right? But that time frame is actually realistic.
Next week, the Starlets travel to Zambia while Shujaa head to South Africa for their respective Olympic qualifiers. And the hope is all the focus can now shift to their performance on the pitch. Mukami Wambora for Citizen TV.